One of the things that came out of the Inflation Reduction Act was this excuse that they were going to be able to save $300 billion. Well, if our opponent was actually present, as opposed to being in France on vacation lying to the American people that it was because of COVID she missed it, she might have understood that the president was going to be passing an executive order to spend more than that in the very same week. Look, here's the reality. There's a lot of people who went through college and worked hard. Some of them are in the audience today. They saved money, they planned for it, they appeared for it. There are others who served in the military and worked hard and served overseas to be able to afford college. And then there are some who are still paying down their college debt, doing it the right way. But the wrong way is for an illegal executive order to spend $20,000, nearly $300+ billion, that takes money that everybody else will be paying. What if we were to invest that money in a trade school or a first-time electrician to help them with their first tool set so they could go out there and follow that apprenticeship? What if we were able to help those young dental hygienists who are desperately needed in our communities? Here in Iowa, we've done it the right way. We've rewarded people in jobs they need when they need it to pay their loans back.
So does Congress have a role in making college more affordable or secondary education more affordable for people?
Absolutely, Congress has a role in this. And I would also say that there needs to be skin in the game from the universities involved. Look, this is going to not pay off debt. Someone is going to inherit this. The colleges themselves have a responsibility to put skin in the game, and this is where I think Congress has a very good opportunity through the commitment to America to make sure education is affordable in those skill sets that we need, whether they be an apprenticeship, a dental hygienist, a college graduate, or a doctor. But most importantly, we need to make sure that those individuals who are taking out debt are doing so in a reasonable way where they can pay it back and not spend a lifetime debted out to a bank or a lending institution or the U.S. government because we have not set those individuals up for success. I will say again, as a military member, I had the privilege of serving my country overseas, and that helped pay for our kids and my wife to be able to go to school. These are the kind of investments that we can make in our communities that are powerful and impactful. If you're a nurse and you want to go back to school, the state of Iowa helps you pay for that, but you have to work in a rural area afterwards. The same for our teachers. If we need teachers, they have the opportunity to serve as long as they'll serve back here in Iowa.